What's up, guys? My name's Tom, and I'm the founder of Crossley Health and Fitness. I'd like to welcome you to my first full body mobility routine, in which I'll be covering a wide range of exercises which are going to hit each body part, from like slow range squats for the legs to upward to downward facing dog for the full body. So if at any point you feel the need to pause the video to rewind if you didn't fully understand the instructions and the techniques, then feel free to do so. This time is for you. We're going to begin nice and simple with this routine. We're going to start off with a bit of flexion and extension of the wrist. So just grip your wrist and slowly extend and flex the wrist. You can keep a clenched fist or you can open the hand. Just aim for full range of motion. There's no need to count reps. We're just going to do a few on each side. Just aiming to unlock the hands and the wrist, which are going to be in use a lot in this routine. Okay, let's begin to supinate and pronate the wrist. So nice posture. Think about bringing your palms up to the ceiling and then turn your palms down to the floor. Just aiming for full range of motion. Keep it nice and relaxed, not forcing anything. And also maintaining good integrity throughout the full body. So let's do a couple more. And we'll take it into hand circles. So clasp the wrist again with your other hand. And full deep circles. Full range of motion. Do a few in one direction. And then start to alternate to the other way. Same again, just maintain good posture, good integrity through the full body, and we'll work both sides. Just loosening off our wrists, it's nice and steady. All right, we'll just do a few more, guys, a few more. Again, showing me going both ways. All right, and good work. All right, bring it down to the ground. So we're going to do quadruped cat-cow to begin with. So start off with your knees hip width, your hands shoulder width. And then we're going to round our spine, tuck our pelvis, let the weight of our head forward, and exhale. And then for the cat variation, slightly arch your spine and just gaze forward as you inhale. And then keep that cycle going. Ensure that you maintain good integrity throughout the full body with this exercise. And it also helps if you spread the fingers and grip the ground so you feel grounded throughout the full exercise. Try to avoid arching your neck too much with the cow variation. Just a slight gaze forward is enough to get a stretch in that aspect of the movement. You don't want to put too much strain on the cervical spine. Alright guys, and we're going to slowly transition to child pose to cobra pose, alternating between the two. Starting with cobra, we want to begin in a prone position, body fully extended with hands underneath the shoulders. Then we're going to grip the ground, press into the earth and raise our upper bodies. As we transition to child pose, the key details here are you want to rest your hips towards your heels, tucking your spine and pelvis in the process, and also resting your torso on your knees and quads and letting the weight of your head just sink into the floor. When in cobra pose, if you want to deepen the stretch, you can look up to the ceiling. Transitioning between the two at your own pace, there's no rushing with mobility training. You want to go through full range of motion and just move in a nice slow manner. Maintaining integrity throughout the full body is key with these exercises. So you want to maintain good posture and also nice, steady, fluent breathing. Deep inhales through the nose and long exhales through the mouth. It's also an option in child pose to come up onto the fingertips to allow a deeper stretch in the shoulders. Okay, so we're going to do one more cycle of this exercise and then we're going to transition to quadruped hip circles, which begins in the same position as a cat-cow, knees hip width and hands shoulder width apart. And same as with some of the previous exercises, you want to grip the ground by spreading your fingertips really wide and ensuring you've got good firm grip of the floor. Okay, so depending on which leg you're using, we're going to keep the leg at a 90 degree angle, kick the leg back and then draw it out to the side and back round. So think about creating a big circle with your knee and just keep that smooth motion, aiming to increase range of motion as you go through each rep. So you want to count this one. So if you do four, kicking back and then out to the side, as we go the opposite way, we go to the side and then back, you want to do four of them also, so we're maintaining good balance. A common mistake with this exercise is collapsing in the hip capsule, collapsing at the pelvis, so you're sinking in. To avoid that, you want to lift up through your midsection, keep your pelvic floor nice and tight and engaged. Alright guys, so I'm switching leg at this point, which doesn't necessarily mean that you need to. So at any time in this video, if you feel you need to pause the video just to readjust or reassess your posture or positioning, just feel free. This is your time to improve your health and well-being. So reassess, make sure you're maintaining good posture and that you're aiming to improve range of motion with each rep. And also counting your reps, make sure you're doing the same number each way and just making big circles with the knee going both ways whilst avoiding collapsing in the hip capsule by keeping your core nice and engaged. Nice work guys, keep it going. I'm going to do a few more and then transition to the next exercise, which is going to be downwards to upward facing dog. So maintain your hands shoulder width apart where they are, and then we're gonna sink our hips into the mat, feet flat, toes pointing back, and then chest up and draw your shoulders back. Same as always, just transition at your own pace here, guys, just take your time. The key details for downward facing dog are to make sure you're grounded into the floor by your feet and your hands. Gripping the ground with your hands, spreading your fingertips, pressing into the mat so your arms are locked out, keeping your legs straight, and then with your feet you want to root your heels into the floor, keeping a nice strong midsection and lifting your tailbone up to the sky. Whilst alternating back and forth, if you feel the need to adjust your feet or your hands, if you feel like you're straining anything, just do so, because I do that all the time. And don't forget to breathe. Breathing is a key point with any type of exercise. If you're holding your breath, you're restricting your body. You want to make sure your body's functioning at its maximum capacity. As you start to open your body up with each rep, each alternate, you want to slowly start to improve the range of motion and go slightly deeper and deeper with each movement. And as you're looking up with upward facing dog, you want to gaze up at your third eye and slightly arch the chin forward so you're engaging the full spine. All right, nice work there, guys. So we're going to transition to our feet, to a standing position. So however you want to do that is up to you. We're going to begin with some slow parallel squats. So we want to stand tall and straight, feet hip to 1.5 hip width apart, and spread your weight evenly through the four corners of your feet. When lowering down for the eccentric phase of the movement, you want to squat nice and slow by opening your sit bones up, digging your weight into your heels, and keeping your chest up, maintaining good posture. And for the concentric phase, you want to drive your weight into all four corners of your feet and more so your heels as you're sinking your hips back. And that's to straighten your legs slowly under control. Exhale as you're coming up and also use your arms to counterbalance yourself. So slow and steady wins the race with this exercise, as it's a slow squat. It's not a calisthenic exercise, it's a mobility, so you want to think about keeping the motion nice and smooth, nice and slow, and just thinking about those key points. All right, nice work there, guys. So for the next exercise, we're going to do a straight leg hip hinge, which requires our feet to be hip width and toes angled forward. Ensure that your spine is nice and aligned, keeping your head up, spine nice and straight. So for the eccentric, where we're lowering to the earth, we're going to lift up through our pelvic floor and midsection, and then slowly slide our hands down our legs, maintaining a flat back and straight legs, and just aim for the full range of motion. Then for the concentric phase, you want to begin to slowly raise back to standing, using the hamstrings, the back muscles and the glutes, maintaining integrity through the full body. Alright, just do a few more reps, guys. Just maintaining all them key points, just sliding your hands slowly down our legs, keeping everything nice and straight and aligned. Just trying to go slightly further each time without arching our backs. And then in the same position, we're going to go into the hip hinge thrust. This begins in the same position. All we're going to do is just open and tuck the pelvis in a nice smooth motion going back and forth. So this one's a little bit more active. You don't need to keep the legs straight. You're just thrusting back and forth. Good for the hip joint, this one. Yeah, and don't forget to breathe. Just exhale as you're thrusting. Inhale as you're opening the sit bones. Just keep that steady motion going. Maintain balance through the feet. So it's quite common to lose balance as you do this if you don't maintain integrity in the feet. Keep everything nice and aligned. All right, and just do a few more. And then we're going to transition to our neck complex. The first of the complex is looking side to side. Just maintaining all them key points, all them techniques, of keeping our posture nice and tall and straight. And just move through the motion nice and slow. Nice, slow and controlled. The neck is a very delicate area, so be careful with yourself on this one. Don't try and strain it too far. Just as much as comfortable. Try to avoid any forcing motion. Just keep the muscles nice and loose, nice and relaxed. Okay, so the next exercise, we're gonna look up and down. And then we're just going to keep alternating between that, slow and controlled. With it being a mobility exercise, we're actively trying to increase range of motion. So look slightly further each time, but like with the previous, don't try and strain anything. You want to do this with integrity. Also keeping your back nice and straight, standing tall. Okay, so just a few more, and then we're going to do the third and final one, which is neck circles, full circles. Just make sure you keep breathing as you're moving, guys. Just try to avoid any holding of the breath, because that's just going to restrict your movement. And quite possibly the neck is the most neglected area in the human body in terms of exercise. So making sure you've got a nice, healthy, flexible neck, mobile neck is important, especially if you're in sports or just in general life, to be honest. All right, guys, so the last one, we're going to be doing full head circles. So if you want to create circles with the crown of the head, going through the full range of motion without straining or pulling anything. So no force in this movement. Just go for it nice and smooth, whatever feels natural for you. So like before with the quadruped hip circles, we want to count. So say we do 5 circles going to the left, we want to do 5 going to the right, so we're not creating any imbalances within the body. And just keep it going at your own pace. Yeah, no stopping and starting, no sharp movements, just nice and steady. All right, nice work there, guys. Looking good. So for the very last exercise, we're going to want to bring our feet all the way together for a Jefferson curl. if that's not feasible for you, you can do hip width apart. So to start off with this exercise, you want to stand nice and tall, and we're unwinding from the head down. So let the weight of your head sag forward, and we're releasing vertebrae by vertebrae until you reach the bottom, so you reach a full range of motion. And then from there, we're going to start to engage the muscles in the back to raise the body up to a standing position. So raising up vertebrae by vertebrae and vice versa. So this one really is really good for your spine. It unlocks your spine, this one. There's no strict pattern for the breathing with this one in terms of exhaling for the concentric or inhaling for the concentric. You just want to make sure you maintain a nice fluid breathing paired with nice fluid relaxed motion. Just going through the full range of motion. Like I say, mobility training is all about going through it nice and slow, feeling your body out, feeling what feels right for your body. Okay, so we're coming up to the last rep now, guys. Last rep of the routine. So when you get to the bottom of the exercise, your full range of motion, you just want to let your head just sag forward, unwind your shoulders, and just let gravity do its work. Once you finish this final repetition and you've completed the concentric phase, this concludes our full body mobility routine. And if you haven't already, like, subscribe, comment for more. It's greatly appreciated, and look out for more content.